are going back to something that is so primitive, probably which we may not need also, right?
Place and have tea. You know, that is how.
So we have seen at times where our patients are really not affordable, I tell you. Cytochemical stains, you know, we may not be doing it, but where patients cannot afford, we definitely look at it. Resource poor. So at least do something. And that even now we have a patient who cannot afford to get the flow cytometry done. So then I may say, okay, let me do at least PA stain and conclude what it is. So that is the setup still that persists in many of the places. So this I tell you the uses next when I go to next. So I've just taken three things here. The objectives are, so when we talk about special stain, there are three domains that we talk about. So first is the cognitive domain. So we need to know, have little knowledge about it. So whatever is required. So next is the psychomotor domain. So that psychomotor domain is doing it. Okay, we have to do it, not just learn the procedure. It's like preparing the cigarette bar. If you just read the recipe, no, you cannot prepare, you have to do it. And third is the affective domain, what I was telling you. So wherever patients cannot afford, at least do something and to at least come to a certain conclusion in cases where it is difficult. As Vikas was showing one of the pictures, we were seeing, you know, the morphology is like myeloblast, but it turned out to be lymphoblast. So in such cases, at least something, because it is so primitive. So we are going back from such hi-fi thing back to what was being done earlier days. So if you just look at AC Lewis, so when we were students, we were buying a previous edition of AC Lewis, thinking the latest editions will deal only with automated techniques, but what we are doing is a primitive one. So previous editions have two chapters, one on erythrocyte cytochemistry, the other on leukocyte cytochemistry. So then the ninth edition, AC Lewis, you just go back and see, it says erythrocyte cytochemistry, leukocyte cytochemistry and immunophenotyping. So now you just look at the 11th edition, it's just one chapter. It just combine erythrocyte cytochemistry and leukocyte cytochemistry. Just few stains that are mentioned. So just show you the pictures of those stains, you can identify and say where they're used. So red cell cytochemistry, so these are the things, of course, you have seen some of these pictures since morning. Yeah. Let us start with this. What is this? Yeah, what stain is this? Ghost. Where do you see ghosts in pathology? Ghost is where? Hematology? Yeah. Fetal hemoglobin. In histopathology, where the ghost gone? Yeah, anywhere else? Ghost cells? Ghost tubules, have you heard of? Where? Totally atrophic tubules? Male infertility? Testicular biopsy. So pyelomatricoma is not only the tumor which shows ghost cells, you can see other pyloid derived tumors which also show ghost cells. So this is K-Hall's acid elution technique. Very simple test to demonstrate fetal hemoglobin. So where is it required? Why is it required? So you heard Dr. Subbarao talking about it. Next. See, can you see two populations of cells? One population of RBCs which are stained, the other population which remain unstained. So these are the cells which contain adult hemoglobin, and these cells are the cells which contain fetal hemoglobin. So this is acid elution test. Very simple. We treat the cells with an acidic buffer. So all the cells containing hemoglobin F, they retain hemoglobin F, adult hemoglobin is eluted. Very simple test. Then after staying with eosin. So we can see this. If you want to go back and do this test, what sample of blood do you take? Only for interest. So whenever we do this test, a positive and a negative control, cord blood becomes a positive control. What becomes a negative control? Protein smear. And adult smear becomes a negative control. So this is, so we were doing this test earlier. You can just see from Daisy Lewis, such an easy procedure. So now nobody does this. So it is on?
Yes.
Very good. Raja says we are still doing it. So just go back and do this smear. Very simple. You don't need to spend any money on this. But when we do cytochemical stains or special stains, we need to know how to prepare buffers. No, so buffer is, one of buffer tablets are very good, just dissolve and prepare the buffer also next. Yeah, this is only to detect fetal-maternal hemorrhage and why is it required and all this morning what Dr. Subbaraman discussed, you know. So these are the cells containing HBF. These are the adult cells which are ghost cells. Okay, just remember the ghost and this pink cells which have HBF. So other conditions where HBF could be present in the cells, delayed disappearance, congenital disorders of HB synthesis, hereditary persistence, beta thalassemia, then sickle cell you heard in the morning, you know that HBF is also present at the combined rate. Next. Next. So we observe the cell, observe the smear first, even if you see one single cell with positive staining, we go back and count it. There's a procedure to count. Now ready test kits are available also to do this. Next. So I won't talk about the procedure because it's only when you are doing it you should know how to count and all that. So what is this?
Reticulocyte.
What would be the color of the cytoplasm in a reticulocyte preparation? You see this color? No. So if you want to make reticulocyte preparation a permanent one, usually we do not fix the reticulocyte preparation, right? We just make a smear and observe it. So you see reticulocytosis and you want to preserve it, what do you do? Just do a Leishman stain on that. Or fix the smear and then in the formalin vapors and then you can do eosin stain also. Next. You have seen a picture of pink spotis? Was it there in the previous sessions? Yes. So do we get to see this? Yes. So they are end products of degradation of hemoglobin and many conditions where we can see. So why we have taken up is when we encounter, you know, in a reticulocyte preparation. So students keep asking, this doesn't look like a reticulocyte but it has something in it. So we need to differentiate what is that present. So there is just 1 to 3 micrometers and 1 or more may be present in a single cell. So they are close to the cell membrane. You saw a nice picture which Dr. Chatterjee showed, you know, which were projecting from the cell. Next. See, these are the things that sometimes we could see in a reticulocyte preparation. So supravital staining is the method by which we can demonstrate the King's bodies. They are not seen in the Romanowski stage, but they appear purple, large or single, but they are slightly lightly stained in supravital staining. So just take a smear from a post splenectomy patient. Now we see many patients with splenectomy. Just observe a peripheral smear on Romanowski stain and then go back and do certain special stains. So these are all the causes or conditions where we can demonstrate or see them. Next. So unstained preparation, you can see them as refractory structures. We all know when we observe an unstained preparation, what is the adjustment of the microscope that has to be done? We need to lower the condenser and reduce the light so that they appear. Otherwise, phase contrast, we can demonstrate them better. See, supravital staining. You see a reticulocyte as well as here you see a Haynes body next. So suppose we do this methyl violet. Where else do we use methyl violet staining? Go out of hematology. Methyl violet, yeah, amyloid, this is not a stain for amyloid, yes, so methyl violet when we stain, so just mix methyl violet next, yeah, so they appear very bright, they could be single or slightly more than, or 1 to 3 in number, so they are appreciated very well with methyl violet stain, very simple stain that could be done. So when we talk about supravital staining, we know the supravital stains. Probably you may use new methylene blue or brilliant crystalline blue. So you can use Janus green also, a supravital stain, where we remove the sign and then when it is still vital or metabolically active with the stain. Where do we use supravital staining? One is to demonstrate lenticulocytes routinely. So out of hematology, supravital staining, fluorescent, okay. Staining, supravital, okay, vital staining, lean supravital, vital staining, okay, lights for, yeah, to demonstrate, okay, then, vital. Don't you see our obstetricians, gynecologists doing colposcopy? No, they apply this, there it becomes vital. So methylene blue, already in blue positive. So that is abnormal area. Or acido white? Yeah, so that is application of dilute acetic acid. Wherever there is abnormality, so a lot of DNA, the nucleoproteins precipitate and it becomes great, more whitish. Next. So this is the previous one. So whenever we do a reticulocyte count, all of us know, so we say use a Miller's disc. I don't know how many of you use it or how many of you have it. So this is only to count the cells precisely. And we know to do a corrective count also. But I'll show you our next picture. So Raja and Ramaswamy remember this. So reticulocyte count, doing a reticulocyte count used to be an exercise for MD students in the examination. And examiners during those days, they were using what is the eyepiece. They were asking the students as to what was the eyepiece used. How did you reduce the image area or the optical area. So everybody, every student used to have this, something like an helix, you know, eyepiece. So with showing that, so you are reducing the area, restricting the area so that you can count better, avoid errors. So here we are seeing, so this is just a Leishman stain preparation where you may not see, this is a reticulocyte preparation and supravital staining, so where we can see the reticulocytes. This all of us know, there was a case, prior presentation, what is this? Golf ball. So which are the cells which have a golf ball appearance, what do they contain? Yes, next. HBH inclusion. See, multiple blue-green spherical inclusions of varying sizes which we can appreciate just in reticulocyte preparation. So when you are encountering reticulocyte, looking at reticulocyte preparation in many of the hemolytic anemia, just have a look at it. Don't just say this doesn't look like reticulocyte and then move further. Just take a minute, look at the slide and decide what it is. So this is the typical golf ball appearance. And you all know what are the conditions where these are present. Next. See, look at this. Next. So when we talk about elution technique for hemoglobin F, there's an elution technique for carboxyhemoglobin or methemoglobin. Right? How many of you encounter methemoglobinemias? No? People in working anesthetists, when they use certain anesthesia, anesthetic drugs, you know, they come out and say that this blood is turning brown. So this is a method, but we usually do not use. I just put it because there is an elution technique for methemoglobin and carboxyhemoglobin also. We do not use it. Next. Yeah. Next. So this is a stain even today all of us are doing. We rely on this technique, this stain, and especially on a bone marrow, we say please do this. Keep one bone marrow slide aside, aspiration slide aside, or this could be done on histopathology also. So what is the color you are seeing here? Yeah. So what blue is this? The Prussian blue. Next. So why Prussian blue? A typical blue color. So predominant uniform color, coat color worn by army soldiers or Kingdom of Prussia. So the positive color, the hemosiderin and the non-heme ion take up this color. We know the principle, a very, very simple methodology. So just mixing hydrochloric acid with potassium ferrocyanide. So the compound which is formed is ferric ferrocyanide, which is this color. But we need to take a control. What control can we take? Yes. So usually, yeah, you can take any. If you have a spleen section also, you can take. I usually take one that corpus luteum or luteum hemorrhagicum. But the problem is we could be taking bone marrow aspiration here and tissue section. So there is slight variation. Otherwise, you can keep the bone marrow positive control always for this. So that's the only difference. And if you have used up all the bone marrow sections for lesional stain, so you can de-stain once. One smear and take it. So how do you decolorize or de-stain? What do you dip this slime in? Methanol. Methanol is the vehicle in which you know the leishman stain is made. So dip the slime in methanol, it decolorizes. But see that the entire blue color is removed. So even if you have old smears, you can just take them back, decolorize and do this pearl stain on that. So all of us know why pearl stain. What are the conditions? What are the situations? Okay, all this cytochemistry now we know complements, right? It's just complementary. So probably we don't depend on this. But it's all of interest. So I told you, post-splenectomy, you take a smear and look at all this. So siderocyte, they're normally not seen. But if, how do they appear in a peripheral smear? Siderocyte? You see, papillary bodies, they are irregular, coarse granules that are present in the RBCs. So there, if you want to call them as siderocyte, just do this Prussian blue technique. Yeah, next. See, the granules, what are these cells? So the granules are around the nucleus. So, yeah, premature, and it's a citroblast. Just two colors, so pink and blue. So if you're using for the nuclei, neutral red, yeah, the nucleus takes a red color. I told you the stored smears, you can use it, decolorize, and then use it next. So we know the types of citroblasts. Okay, I don't need to describe them and tell, you know, what is the number and how they should be, all that. So depending on how they are distributed, we divide them into three types. Next. Yeah. So these are the Papenheimer bodies. The coarse irregular granules that are seen in the RBCs on staining with Prussian blue. If they take the blue, then you call them as siderocytes. Next. Yeah. So then these are the bone marrow pictures. Normal, absent. Each one of them gives a lot of information. So this is increased, this is grossly increased. So how do we say? We have a grading system. So this grading system you should know, or just put a chart on the table so that whenever you are examining a bone marrow with pearl stain, so you can grade them. Next. Yeah. So none is no iron granules at all. Very heavy is very large deposits. Next. Next. See, you can follow this methodology. And you know, and this is always supported by the ferrokinetics. So the studies which we have associated the biochemical findings which help us to conclude. So this is how we divide this, if we know. So how many siderocytes are there, what is the amount of iron that is present in the cells, and what are all the different conditions. So three things at least we'll remember in relation to hematology. So fetal hemoglobin, which Raja says we keep doing even we keep doing it. Demonstration of cells containing HbA. Then supravital staining. I can tell you about how it has to be done, reticulocyte and all that, because it's a routine stain. It's not a special stain. So in the reticulocyte preparation, what are the things that we can do? Or if you want to do a use methyl violet, how you can demonstrate brightly appearing Haynes bodies. And third is a pearl stain, which is useful for the bone marrow aspiration, for the bone marrow biopsy, and even other conditions in histopathology where we need to identify or demonstrate iron. So the next task is why leukocyte cytochemistry? I told you, nobody, I don't think, we even buy. So we had bought all the substrate and all that long back. So never after that we have bought all this. It is of historical interest. You can't just say, oh, to differentiate AML, ALL and all that. So your generation will never accept it, but I just tell you how we were doing all this. And doing cytochemistry was something great during those days. That was, you know, two decades prior or earlier. But just know about it in case you get a question in the examination. Yeah, so now we have all this. Purpose is to characterize, but you will all laugh at it when I say, yeah, this has to be done. But I tell you, you are all used to cooking in a microwave or whatever, you know, the modern gadgets you have. But in case if all these do not work, then you may have to resort to the old technique what probably your grandmother, not even your mother, no, grandmother was using. So all these, lipid cytoplasmic abnormalities, I even had taken up one of the dissertation topic, you know, NBT test. So we call it as NBT revisited to appreciate the phagocytic activity of the neutrophils. That was one and off decades back, I think. So we really found it interesting. So one topic which, one of the topics probably to be given to a postgraduate, where I feel her involvement also would be there. So she will also learn to do a technique, whether it's a primitive technique or a modern technique. So identify your rods. Yes. So all these cytochemical procedures, it is the principle. There is an enzyme, use a substrate, then you see a color product. So types. See, enzymatic, non-enzymatic. When we look at enzymatic, still we are using PAS, collodion blue and pearl stain. No, we have not said these are obsolete. We are still using them. But these are the enzymes which I don't think we are using, but doing it. Next. What is this? A cytochemistry picture from a smear where cytochemistry is done to demonstrate an enzyme. What is this? Why do you say it's myeloperoxidase? There is a control here, right? So along with WBCs, there are RBCs. What do they contain? Peroxidase. So this is myeloperoxidase. So every slide should have a control. This becomes a self-control RBCs. Yeah, myeloperoxidase present in isophilic granules. They are present in eosinophils, basophils also. So aurods are better visualized with this. You may say aurods are better visualized in a peripheral smear which is nicely stained. But still you want to highlight, you can use this. Next. So we were using, you know, this is again a very very easy stain. So we are using benzidine and then demonstrating this. Control I showed you, erythrocytes. Next. So principle is MPO splits hydrogen peroxide. So this is a potent reagent. Whenever we do a test that uses hydrogen peroxide, we say it has to be fresh one and active. Where do we use this hydrogen peroxide? Stay for UG practicals. We say don't use it, but still we use it. Where? Which test? Benzidine test. Okay. So if this is stained, if it doesn't give out nascent oxygen, the test becomes negative in spite of urine being red in color. So still you see, even for UG curriculum, hope with the CBME we take off all these primitive tests, still benzidine test is being done. So a reaction product is brown and granular. Next. Yeah. Next. I won't deal with this methodologies. Next. So reaction product, I told you, all this, you know. So as the cells mature, they have more of these strongly staining granules. The granulocytic
series have this next.
So some individuals have congenital deficiency of this myeloperoxidase, then we may not be able to demonstrate that. Next. See, what is it that is highlighted here? Aurods, yes. So Aurods is so well seen on Leishman stain, but with MPO and Sudan black, which is almost gives results like MPO. So we may demonstrate certain more, you know, other structures which also look like Aurods. They call as P bodies. There are peroxidative drop particles that produce crystalline cellular inclusion. So you may appreciate many of them. See Aurods. What is this stain? So one of these pictures which Dr. Chatterjee had included, so where the primitive or the maturing myelocyte, myeloid series, you know, showed black granules. Can you appreciate these structures here? They're all our rods. Okay, this is Sudan black. What else appears black? Which of the special stain gives a black product? End result? All silver stains, the end product is black. Then, anything else? I will give you an example of iota. Barrow's elastic stain. Anything else which gives a black color, which is also a fixative? Yeah, reticulin. Okay. It's a stain as well as a fixative.
Osmium tetroxide.
Very difficult, you know, to handle this. Neuropathology. Yeah. Osmium tetroxide. A stain as well as a fixative. So black end product. So Sudan black, a lipophilic dye. We say this all in that substance. The results are exactly similar to that of MPO. Yeah. So very easy procedure. See, just good. So many times we say when you want to do certain cytochemical tests on peripheral smear, we say fix the smears in formaldehyde vapors. How do you fix it? Can we just keep the slide in the grossing room, which is not well ventilated, where a lot of formalin fumes are there, making the smear get fixed? So if you are asked to fix a smear in formaldehyde vapor, what do you do? Very easy, just dip some cotton in 40% formaldehyde, formalin. So put it at the base of a popline jar, put the smear, close it off. Then it gets fixed. So formaldehyde vapor, even for PAs, you can do that. Or use methanol or ethanol, that should be fine. Next. Next. So this is how the maturing myeloid series of cells show positivity. So the black granules and nuclei appear blue here. Could we do Leishman on that? Next. So results are similar to MPO stain. Next. So we are moving on to the next one. So MPO myeloperoxidase over Sudan black. Is this Leishman stain? No. Why no? Our disease are appearing somewhat greenish and we are not happy with the cytoplasmic granules or neutrophils. Okay. See, they ranked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So to rank, what should be there? What does it depend on? The ranking depends on the scores. So I have given you a word score. So this is again a stain of historical importance. This is LAP. What is LAP? LAP, neutrophil alkaline phosphatase, or leukocyte alkaline phosphatase. So we have just enjoyed doing all these stains, I tell you. And a control is a must. So we know, whenever, even if we ask undergraduates to say, are leukocyte alkaline phosphatase to differentiate between CML and leukemoid, myeloid-leukemoid react. So this is historical interest now. We've heard Anand Vikas and everybody talking about what is the present era, what are the tests that are being done. So we need to have a control, right? What control could be taken here? Just imagine, think of leukemoid reaction. And what control could be taken? So we need a patient who has leukocytosis, neutrophilia, or even toxic granules. Sepsis. That can easily get a smear from. Neonates then, just go to a toxemia ward. You know, pregnancy toxemia. So just get a smear. Positive control, and negative would be a normal adult smear. Next. Yeah. So scoring, and of course this is a, yeah, next. Go next. Yeah. Control and this I told you. So depending on how the granules are, so we used to score them and say this is the normal score. No granules is 0, 1 plus is occasional, and 4 plus is heavy positivity. So normal is 35 to 100 and high in all these conditions. So low score is what is important. We say CML and some of these conditions like PNH and sickle cell. Next. Yeah. So we are moving on to, so we finished one phosphatase, right? What is this?
Trap.
What is this? What is this?
Hair.
Okay, next. What is this?
Is
it? What is this trap?
Tartrate
resistant acid phosphatase. Yes. So simple one. So we say trap for hemicellulopenia. There's one more condition. Even infectious mononucleosis, trap. So in spite of treating these cells with tartrate, the color remains. They're resistant. The cells show reddish granules in the cytoplasm. Next. See, this is how they appear. Next. So TRAC again positive. So one more remember is infectious mononucleosis. Next. So this was a stain. We just did it 2 days back. When a picture is not clear, what is this color? Magenta. Where do we get magenta color as a positive end product with special stain? Yeah. Why do we get magenta there? Where is magenta? First stain contains what? Skip reagent. What is skip reagent? Skip reagent consists of? What is the color of the reagent?
Colorless.
Okay. Why magenta? How do you prepare skip reagent? Now ready stains are available. So if you really prepare on your basic question, then that means you know to prepare the shift reagent. You must have struggled. People who have prepared, it would have struggled. So I've always followed Lee's cold shift. Okay? So what is the stain that you take? Basic question. So it has rosanoline, pararosanoline, and magenta too. So that is the end product. So how do you know the shift reagent is potent? What do you do? Formalin. What do you do with formalin? Take a watch glass. Take 40% formalin. 1 or 2 ml. Okay. Just add 1 drop of the shift reagent that you have prepared. So immediate, because it is aldehyde, right? So immediately, as soon as you add this leuco shift reagent, so the formalin becomes this magenta color. Then only you say it is potent. Okay, this stain is one. What is this cell? Can you appreciate? I think the picture is not the previous one. The picture is not clear. This one? Next.
Yes.
Yeah. What is this cell? Neutrophil. So that is a control. So neutrophil has taken or appearing positive. So then there are the cells here, the blasts which showed nice blocks of PAS positivity. The picture is not clear. So principle, all of us know, you need to know, because one of the special stains that you may not be doing in MBA examinations now, but you are given a special stain to interpret. So there would be questions on that. So pyritic acid chip, what it oxidizes 1,2-glycol groups of carbohydrate to produce thialdehyde. So that is the one which reacts with leukobasic question and restores the color of the solution. Yes. So AML and ALL, so we have tried this out. Had a child, and you know, the morphology really was like subjective. Some people said myoblast, somebody said lymphoblast. and patient could not afford, you know, for flow cytometry or any of the other investigations. Maybe we are trying to send him next to Kidwa. But at least for us, along with the clinical findings that are helping us to come to a diagnosis, so we could do only one of these stains. Next. What is the control for PAS in tissues? Yeah. Many a times you may forget to take an appendix slide. You want to discard whatever stain you have done, telling that I have not taken a control stain. Control slide. Basement maintenance. Basement maintenance. Self-control. Yeah. Don't want the procedure. Everybody knows this procedure. Next. This is how we could appreciate blocks of PAS positivity in ALL. Next. So there are so many cells in hematology that which are PAS positive. Now you should know about the erythroblasts in erythroleukemia also. Let's see, acute megakaryocytic leukemia M7, then PAS positivity in M6. Next. What is this? It's a cell in mitosis. You can see so nicely the chromosome. What is the end product of this special stain? Color? Color is the same, just like that of PAS, right? So what is it that is demonstrated here? Nucleic acid, DNA. What stain is this? Occlusion reaction. Just like if you have shift reagent, you can do the stain on that. But yeah. But here it is only acid. Next. See, HCl. We use HCl acid hydrolysis. So nicely you can demonstrate. Just remember, fusion for demonstrating DNA. What else could be used for demonstrating DNA? Any fluorescent technique? Fluorescent dye skin name? Yes? Acridine orange, yes. Okay, next. Do we use the stain toluidine blue? Where do you use toluidine blue?
Muscles.
Where do you want to demonstrate muscles? Bone marrow. What are the conditions where there is mastocytosis in the bone marrow? You know the list of conditions? Yeah. So even megaloblastic anemias, you know, many a times we see mastocytosis. We could appreciate them in Leishman stain as darkly staining granules, but do a toluidine blue stain, what happens? What type of stain is toluidine blue? Exactly. What is metachromasia? Yeah, it gives a different color other than the granules. You know the different types of metachromasia also, depending on what color they give. So toluidine blue is one. Even the basophils take up this color. So we had done on two or three bone marrow smears for one of our pages. Otherwise tissues, you know, most of the lesions, you know, demonstration of mast cells. Yeah. Esterases, I'll just go through with specific esterases and non-specific esterases. So non-specific now. Next. Yeah, previous one. So Roger, the reaction is reaction product is bright red. And next, mature stages stain strongly when you want to interpret this. And or Roger positive for fluorescein esterases. So these are the other esterases are for monocytes and their precursors. Monocyte component of AML would be demonstrated well with these esterases. Yeah. See monocytes. Next. We may do a combined stain also. So we definitely found this very difficult to do this test also those days. And now it is of historical interest. You may just say esterases, classify them as specific and non-specific. So chloracetic, where is it positive? And the other esterases in monocytic differentiation. The last one. Can you tell me what is this stain? Based on the color? There are two colors, right? What are the two colors? Green and red. So what are the greens you know in special stains?
Green.
What are all the greens?
Malachite
green, okay. Then?
Apple
green, that is biofragrance, okay. Then? There's no dye or stain. What is apple green? Then? Okay. I'll give you a clue word here. Clue cell. Plasma cell. This is red. But then red would be prominent and green would be less. This again demonstrates RNA, DNA. Methyl green pyrimidine. Very nice stain where we say plasma cells have pyroninophilia to demonstrate plasma cells. You know the conditions where you want to do it. You may do it on histopathology sections also. So the DNA takes a green, blue, whereas the RNA takes a reddish color and the nucleoli. So they take a reddish color. So this is methyl green pyronin stain. Again, especially to demonstrate plasma cells, you know the conditions where plasma cells could be demonstrated. So that is about a few of the stains that you just need to remember. So carry home message is only if you know the name of the stain and interpretation, you can go back and read about the conditions where they're there. Still you may expect this as one of the questions in your MD examination. So the last slide, if you just see, yeah, next. So this speaks a lot. At least somewhere, sometime when you are in a very, very primitive setup, so you may have to go back, you know. So look at this to help the patient. So that is the affective domain I was talking about. Three things: the cognitive, the knowledge domain, which includes interpretation also. Then psychomotor, where you need to do the test. So you need to be colorful. So start working in the laboratory. So if you start working and if you know how to do many of the techniques, whether in hematology or histopathology, so you can be authoritative. Otherwise, you listen to the technician, whatever he says, you agree. So please don't do that. So if you're a good cook, you will know how to work in the laboratory also. So I told you there's a room heater. Yes, all the time it's not available, but weather is very cold. So you are in a forest, so you say, yeah, bonfire. Or you want to get married, you say Agni Sakshi. And you go there. You will not have any sophisticated heat or whatever, you know, fire emitting thing. So I don't repeat what is the take home message, but try doing lot of stains. Not many are there in hematology, but do it in histopathology. So learn to do all the stains that are available and try to interpret. So that all these complement or help us in final diagnosis. So thank you. I think I have not exceeded my time, and I thank Raja for giving me this opportunity to be with you all and spend about half an hour just recollecting what we were doing, so which probably has become obsolete now, but still let us, she says no. She's a positive person, you know, so much confident. So keep doing all this and learn. So do the best for the patient in a given situation. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.